Before we begin, let's have a word from our sponsor. This video is sponsored by Unacademy. Unacademy offers live classes on various competitive exams, including IPMAT, DOJAT, NPAT, and various other BBA exams. About 2 weeks before, they started their comprehensive 1 year and 2 year live batches. This course includes live interaction sessions with experienced faculty, recorded lectures so that, you know, just in case you miss a lecture or you want to watch the lecture again, you can do that unlimited number of times. They also have doubt clearing sessions, daily sectional tests, and tons of full length mocks. They also offer free sectional tests on their website every day at 4:30 p.m. So if you are an IPM aspirant, I think you should definitely give them. It will be a very good practice for you. They also have a YouTube channel where they post academic content regarding IPM. Recently, they started a Telegram channel as well, where they post regular updates about IPM along with tests and quizzes. Lastly, you can also check out their paid course on their website. The link is in the description box. You should definitely use the code RTI10 and get a 10% discount on your total cost. They have various plans ranging from 1 month to 24 months, so make sure you have a look at it once. Now, let's continue with the video.
Now, rule number 8 talks about how some nouns are plural in form but singular in meaning and therefore take a singular verb. For example, the news regarding opening of schools in Delhi is false. In this sentence, you see news is plural in form but singular in meaning and therefore takes a singular verb. Calculus is a tricky subject to master. In India, politics is accompanied by religion. Now, do make a note here that this is not an exhaustive list of all of these nouns that are plural in form but singular in meaning. These are just a few examples I've used there. So we need to make sure that we understand the nature of the subject, whether it is singular in meaning or plural in meaning, disregarding the fact how it seems in the form. Rule number 9 talks about how units of measure usually take singular verb. For example, 20 minutes is the duration of the episodes of a sitcom. 2 liters of water a day is good for the body. 2 lakh rupees is a large sum to give as advance payment. In all of these 3 sentences, I've taken units of measure. In the first one, I've taken time. In the second one, I've taken liters. In the third one, I've taken money. And this is the rule that was applied in the first example we've used in this session, which was 500 rupees is too much for this dress. So now you know that units of measure take a singular verb. Rule number 10 talks about how when some, half, none, more, or all are used, or when fraction and percentages are used, the object of our preposition decides plural or singular form. Now, what do I mean by object of preposition? For example, some of the dal was spilled on the tablecloth. In this sentence, I've used the word some, and then our object of preposition is dal, which is singular in nature, and that is why we've used a singular verb. Similarly, in the second sentence, I've used the same word some, but I've changed my object of preposition from dal to shops. Shops, being a plural subject, take on a plural verb, which is are. Half of the cake was eaten by me. In this sentence too, cake, our object of preposition is singular in nature, and that is why we've used a singular verb. Whereas in the fourth sentence, half of the students were absent on Monday. Students, being a plural subject, take on a plural verb. Now, rule number 11 is very important for your exam because it talks about collective nouns. Now, the treatment of collective nouns for subject-verb agreement takes place in 2 parts. The first part says that we take a singular verb when the collection is thought of as one whole. For example, the band is playing at the arena tonight. The jury has given its decision. In both of these sentences, the collective noun is acting as one whole. It has the same ideas, opinions, and thoughts, and therefore is a singular subject. The second part says that it takes a plural verb when the individuals of the collective noun are thought of. which means that the individuals have different ideas, opinions, and thoughts, and therefore are not acting as one whole. For example, the jury have been unable to reach at a consensus. The committee are divided on the admission process for the new school. In both of these sentences, the collective noun is not acting as one whole and is therefore a plural subject, which goes on to take a plural verb. This brings us to the last rule of today's session. And it is a very simple rule which says that the titles of books, movies, and other similar works take singular verb. For example, The Avengers is my favorite Marvel movie. Friends is the greatest television show of all time. The Unhoneymooners is a romance novel by Christina Lauren. You can see that in all three sentences, I've used titles of books, movies, television shows to showcase how all of these similar works take singular verbs. Now, this brings us to the end of our rules for today's session. But we do need to practice what we've learned today. And therefore, we'll now attempt an exercise to understand the rules of subject-verb agreement even better. So, the first question of the exercise is, all the CDs, even the scratched one, are slash is in this case. The answer to the first question is, all the CDs, even the scratched one, are in this case. Because in this sentence, we need to identify the subject. Our subject is all the CDs, which is a plural subject and will therefore take a plural verb. The second question is, the Prime Minister, together with his wife, greets slash greets the press. Now, the answer to this question would be greets. The Prime Minister, together with his wife, greets the press. This is because the Prime Minister is a singular subject and will therefore take a singular verb. The third question, 12 kilometers is slash are a long distance to walk. Now, the answer to this question would be 12 kilometers is a long distance to walk. This is because 12 kilometers is a unit of measure. And we've learned now that units of measure always take a singular verb. Now, this brings us to the fourth question. Is slash are the tweezers in this drawer? Well, the answer to this question is, are the tweezers in this drawer? This is because tweezers are a plural subject and will therefore take a plural verb. The fifth question. The man with all the birds live slash lives on my street. The answer to the fifth question would be lives. The man with all the birds lives on my street. This brings us back to the first rule of our session, the error of proximity. The birds is the noun nearest to the verb, but we need to identify the subject of this sentence, which is the man, which is a singular subject and will therefore take a singular verb. Either answer is slash are acceptable. The answer to this question is, either answer is acceptable. This is because we've learned that either, each, everyone, many, always take a singular verb. Now the seventh question. The United States is slash are bordered by Mexico and Canada. Well, the answer to this question is, the United States is bordered by Mexico and Canada. And this is because we've learned that proper names always take a singular verb. There goes slash go the president. The answer to this question would be, there goes the president. Now we've used goes, which is a singular verb, because our subject is singular, the president. Ninth question, a pile of books sits slash sit on the shelf. The answer to the ninth question would be, a pile of books sits on the shelf. This is because our subject is a pile and pile is a singular subject. This brings us to the 10th question. The price of that pair of gloves was slash were 200 rupees. The answer to this question is was. The price of that pair of gloves was 200 rupees. This is because our subject here is the price. Our subject is not the pair of gloves. It is the price of the gloves that we are talking about. And therefore, we will use a singular verb. The next question. The class members is slash are debating among themselves. Now, this is a very important point of collective noun that we've discussed. The answer to this question would be the class members are debating among themselves. Because in this question too, we see that the individuals are not acting as one whole. The individuals have different thoughts, opinions, and ideas, and therefore they're taken as a plural subject. The next question. One of the main reasons for elephant poaching are/is the profits received from selling the ivory tusks. The answer to this question would be is. The one of the main reasons for elephant poaching is the profits received from selling the ivory tusks. This is because our subject here is one of the main reasons. So we are talking about one reason here, therefore a singular verb. Now the 13th question. Neither the explorer nor his companions was/were ever seen again. Now the answer to this question is neither the explorer nor his companions were ever seen again. Please note that in this sentence, we have joined a singular subject and a plural subject. Therefore, the nature of the verb is according to the nature of the subject that is closest to it. That is, his companions, a plural subject and therefore a plural verb. Now the 14th question. Measles is/are a contagious childhood disease? The answer to this question would be is. This is because measles is kind of a noun that is plural in form, but its meaning is singular. And therefore, we will use a singular verb to go along with it. Our last question of the session is, never has/have the weather been so bad in the months of June and July? Now, the answer to this question is, never has the weather been so bad in the months of June and July. Now, this is because the subject here is the weather. We are talking about the weather in the months of June and July, and weather is a singular subject. Therefore, the verb would be singular. Well, this brings us to the end of our session for today. I hope I did not bore you too much. And I hope it was a fun and interesting session for you, wherein you were able to clear all your doubts regarding subject-verb agreement. I sincerely hope you were able to reach a certain level of clarity on the topic, which you maybe did not have before. And I would just tell you to practice as much as you can, because practicing the topic will help you ace the topic. Other than that, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for staying till the end.